summer I turned 18. We lived in a one-room run-down shack on the outskirts of New Orleans. We didn't have money for food or rent, to say the least, we were hard-pressed. Then Mama spent every last penny we had to buy me a dancing dress. Well, Mama washed and combed and curled my hair, and she painted my eyes and lips. Then I stepped into a satin dancing dress that had a split from the side clean up to my hip. It was red velvet trimming and it fitting me good. And standing back from the looking glass, there stood a woman where a half-grown kid had stood. She said, here she wants his fancy, don't let me down. She said, here she wants his fancy, don't let me down. Mama dad a little bit of perfume on my neck, then she kissed my cheek. And then I saw the tears welling up in her troubled eyes as she started to speak. She looked at a pitiful shack and then she looked at me and took a ragged breath. She said, your paw's runned off and I'm real sick and the baby's gonna starve to death. She handed me a heart-shaped locket that said, to thine own self be true. And I shivered as I watched a roach crawl across the toe of my high-heel shoe. It sounded like somebody else that was talking, asking, Mama, what do I do? She said, just be nice to the gentleman fancy, they'll be nice to you. She said, here's your one chance fancy, don't let me down. Here's your one chance fancy, don't let me down. People came and took the baby, Mama died and I ain't been back. But the wheels of fate started to turn, and for me there was no way out. It wasn't very long till I knew exactly what my mama been talking about. I knew what I had to do when I made myself this solemn vow. I was gonna be a lady someday, though I didn't know when or how. But I couldn't see spending the rest of my life with my head hung down in shame. You know I might have been born just plain white trash, but fancy was my name. She said, here's your one chance, fancy, don't let me down. She said, here's your one chance, fancy, don't let me down. It wasn't long after a benevolent man took me in off the streets. 1 week later I was pouring his tea in a five-room hotel suite.
Yes, you were.
I charmed a king, a congressman, and an occasional aristocrat. And then I got me a Georgia mansion in an elegant New York townhouse flat. And I ain't the man. Now in this world there's a lot of self-righteous hypocrites, they call me bad. And criticize Mama for turning me out, no matter how little we've had. But though I ain't had to worry about nothing from now on 15 years, well, I can still hear the desperation in my poor mama's